You're watching CW Montana. This is the MTN 9 o'clock news.
And good evening. Thanks for joining us on this Tuesday. I'm Andrea Lutz. A lot developing in the state of Montana tonight, including this. A Billings man accused of murdering his girlfriend and then fleeing to Nevada is back in Montana custody and before a judge. We're going to check in on this case. Plus, Montana Attorney General Tim Fox is at the southern border, learning how those crossing the border illegally could be impacting our state. We're going to have the details on his trip. And the dangers of rushing waters taking hold in Montana this week. How three separate incidents in the state are bringing the issue of water safety to the forefront. Well, we do start out of Great Falls tonight. That's where we're getting some late breaking details about a river rescue on the Missouri River. It's kept Great Falls rescue crews pretty busy. The details are still coming in tonight, but here is what we do know. Police and fire responded to the report of a river rescue at Meadowlark Country Club. As crews worked the scene, our cameras caught crews pulling a jet ski out of the water. And there you see Great Falls using a drone to investigate. Of course, they were flying that drone up and down the Missouri River. As I said, we are still getting some details on this one, but we'll be sure to let you know when we get some more information. Tonight, new information on a two-day search for a missing diver in Canyon Ferry Reservoir. Help from surrounding counties brought in to aid in that search. And tonight, authorities say they finally pulled that diver's body out of the water this afternoon. MTN's Jonathan Anbarian joins us from the Yacht Basin Marina.
Crews had been searching much of the day Tuesday in the area north of Cemetery Island. Around 2:30 Tuesday afternoon, they confirmed the location of the diver's body. The search had started Monday afternoon. Authorities say the diver had been in the water when he suffered an equipment problem. Another man went into the water to help him. The second diver was eventually brought to shore and taken to the hospital, but crews could not locate the first diver on Monday. On Tuesday, the Lewis and Clark County Sheriff's Office Water Emergency Team and Lewis and Clark Search and Rescue were back on the water. They also got assistance from the Flathead County Sheriff's Office, which brought in a dive team and advanced sonar equipment.
They were able to coordinate it down to a smaller search area and found his body in the water, where dive teams were able to go down and bring him up. Thanks to all the volunteers and the hard work of everybody involved to bring closure for the family.
The sheriff's office said the man was from Massachusetts, but they are not yet releasing his identity. At Canyon Ferry, Jonathan Ambarian, MTN News.
An early morning pursuit ultimately left a 16-year-old boy dead after police say he jumped into the Clark Fork River in Missoula after stealing a car. It all started at 7:30 this morning. That's when police were alerted of a stolen car out of Washington State. When stopped, the boy jumped out of the vehicle and into the Clark Fork. At one point, he did come back out of the water to talk with officers, but then jumped back into the water and went under. The teen's body was recovered near Silver Lagoon Park. The man accused of murdering his girlfriend in Billings last fall says he didn't do it. 54-year-old Gregory Green was just brought back from Nevada on Sunday, is charged with killing Laura Johnson last September. Green pleaded not guilty to deliberate homicide during a brief court appearance in Billings this morning, and Johnson is still missing. Prosecutors, though, say they've got evidence to prove Green killed Johnson and disposed of her body. Tonight could be a big night for Bozeman School District as a new superintendent is set to be announced. Right now, board members are deliberating and the finalists are down to three. Sarah Brown from Florida, Christopher Hines from Texas, and Montanan Robert Connors, who served as Glasgow superintendent for over 5 years. Our MTN team in Bozeman is following this story. They're at that meeting. They're going to have the latest for you on the 10 o'clock news. The Montana State Auditor reviewing a complaint alleging Secretary of State Corey Stapleton used a state vehicle to commute home. The report says Stapleton racked up 1,000 miles, using a state vehicle in just 18 months. Well, state law says employees can't use state vehicles to go home, but Stapleton says it was allowed for an office mission. Still, the auditor doesn't authorize more than 30 miles. Of course, Stapleton lives in Billings. The AG's office is reviewing those findings. Governor Steve Bullock is headed to that presidential debate stage for July after qualifying now for Detroit. Bullock met the qualifications with a 1% poll number, but Bullock still has some work to do for the actual debate. He's the 21st candidate to qualify, but the committee limits it to 20. It's a series of tiebreakers, and that's how they'll determine who actually takes the stage. Montana Attorney General Tim Fox says the crisis at the U.S.-Mexico border is directly impacting the safety of Montana. Fox has been at that border since Sunday, meeting with law enforcement, and he says illicit drugs are making their way into our country and into Montana. Fox is running for governor in 2020, took the opportunity to say that his firsthand look at the border makes him a better informed advocate.
Much of the crime in Montana, it's no secret, is driven by the increase in drugs coming to our state from across our southern border. And there's only so much we alone can do in Montana. And while my office has ramped up operations with our federal, tribal, and local enforcement, law enforcement partners, the solution must be a national effort.
Fox is one of three prominent Republicans running for the governor's seat, and we want to let you know there are two Democrats that are also in that race. Well, with budgets tight and crime on the rise, law enforcement agencies across Montana are hoping to get a piece of some federal funding. Local agencies gathered in Missoula for a brainstorming session with the Department of Justice and on tap discussing how rural police can get more money through grants. In the past year, Montana experienced an increase in crime. More resources, they say, could help curb that trend.
The resources into Montana are incredibly important. You know, Montana, as we've talked about, has seen a 35% increase in violent crime from 2013 to 2017. We're dealing with serious substance abuse issues, not only opioids, but a meth crisis. You add those issues and then other burdens on law enforcement, for instance, a lot of appropriate focus on missing and murdered indigenous women and the need to find missing people puts an added burden on law enforcement, especially in rural law enforcement. And so to the extent that we can get federal dollars that are intended for this use back into our state, back working for the taxpayers that paid them in, is good for Montana.
Law enforcement leaders came from as far as Roosevelt County to take part in that forum from really all corners of the state. Leaders in Butte are pushing for a second flight out of the Burt Mooney Airport, which currently only flies to Salt Lake City. The Fly Butte campaign is pushing to raise $200,000, and they hope to entice United Airlines to also now fly to Denver. Officials say the sooner the money is raised, the more Butte will benefit.
This is exactly how all the other communities statewide have done it. So if you look at the airports in Bozeman, Missoula, Kalispell, Great Falls, Billings, I mean, this is how they're growing their airport.
What we need to do as a community is we need to put some funds together so that we can have a revenue guarantee so that then we can seriously look at bringing in an additional flight.
So there is going to be a public meeting at the airport. It's going to be this Thursday night, and it's going to be there to discuss some fundraising campaign goals. All right, there are some questions tonight surrounding the repair of the Bogart Shell Ice Rink in Bozeman, this 3 months after that roof caved in from heavy snow. Well, other than some new fencing, the shell looks pretty much the same as the day that that roof collapsed back in March. And community members remain concerned over the project. City officials are trying to determine the cost of repairs after learning that insurance is actually not going to cover the damages.
I think this incident has really elevated that conversation and awareness to really how important these facilities are as a public asset. We really are taking this seriously and want to make sure that we can repair what's there.
And the department plans to bring the issue to the Board of Commissioners. They hope to do that in July. A new station for a growing district, the Missoula Rural Fire District, is proposing relocating their primary fire station to a brand new location, all in an effort to improve response times. The district will ask voters to approve a bond, but say taxpayers won't see an increase because of the existing budget. The plan is to move from the location on South and Reserve to Big Sky Park, and fire leaders say this will improve their response times.
The new station would not require a mill levy, would not require a bond measure, okay? We can fund this new station, obviously through financing, over a period of 30 to 40 years, and not have to ask for a bond measure or a mill levy increase. It's in our current budget right now.
Missoula Rural Fire District leaders say the district has changed considerably over the years, but they have stayed at that same location there on South and Reserve for the past 50 years. Well, Second Lady Karen Pence, well, she got a dose of Billings sass during her visit to the Magic City just last week. But between the biscuits at the Sassy Biscuit, that restaurant there, and the Billings hospitality, the Second Lady also learned about the issues facing military wives. So despite some newfound friendships there, the Sassy Biscuit owners say they were not going to share that signature recipe with the Second Lady's staff. Instead, though, it is now an official Billings tradition for the Second Lady whenever she does visit Montana next. All right, well, we have been following the journey of the USS Billings pretty closely. It's that ship that's soon going to be commissioned this summer. As it happens, we're also checking in on the construction of the USS Montana. Today in Helena, folks got the chance to learn more about crews from the USS Montana and the USS Helena. Well, the USS Montana is a nuclear-powered fast attack submarine. It's currently still under construction. The USS Helena, which served the nation for the past three decades, is being refitted in Virginia, close to where they're doing construction on the USS Montana. And the USS Montana is expected to be completed and commissioned in 2021. A lot of Montana ties hitting the oceans soon. Still to come tonight on the MTN 9 o'clock news, we're going to show you how these good boys right here are helping track down on drug crimes in the Flathead Valley. We're going to have that story coming up. But first, hey, Bob, we're approaching that summer solstice. How are things looking in the weather department?
Well, we've had some strong to near severe thunderstorms across much of eastern Montana today, but now it looks like there's a new cold front moving in, one that could bring some snow. We'll tell you where and when in a few more minutes.